Hello, welcome to another episode of Everyday Amazing. I am your host, Guy Elton, and tonight we have one of Sacramento's funniest comedians. You don't want to go anywhere. Stay tuned.
Everyday Amazing with Sky Elton. Everyday Amazing. Everyday Amazing with Sky Elton. Everyday Amazing. Everyday Amazing, Sky out.
Welcome to another episode of Everyday Amazing. And as always, I'm trying to bring you guys some of the hottest, amazing people coming out of SAC. And tonight, I have one of the funniest comedians coming out of Sacramento, Mr. Lance Woods. How you doing?
Hey, hey, I'm sensational. First off, who was the dude in the video?
Oh man, that's me.
No, it's not. Not with the Junetown hair. That wasn't you. That was somebody. Who was that?
You know, that's classic me. This is Junetown me.
When did you hit the Slim Shady? When did that happen?
Season 3, you know, I had to switch it up a little bit, you know, stand out.
Once they get to a third season, they get different. Always remember that. Season 3 is different. The first two seasons, it's like, I don't know where it's going. People stay humble. Soon as season 3 hit, that third season check, they get to dyeing their hair different colors. They got exotic rings on, puka shells, and that third button coming down. Fourth season, third button coming down. Guarantee it. Fourth season, all whole shirt open.
Oh,
I've seen people change. This is no different. Go ahead.
You ain't lying. You ain't lying. You ain't lying. Okay, now first off, man, I want to let the people know just more about you. So I know you because I've seen you all over Instagram. You have some of the funniest content on Instagram right now. But I want the people to know more about like how you got your start to being a comedian. Because I understand like you were an actor first, right? Did you get your first start in acting?
No. I started comedy in my church.
Okay.
I was imitating my pastor, long story short, and then that went to comedy clubs and so on and so forth.
Okay.
So I started in my church doing comedy. Then once the comedy clubs hit, then it goes from there. But I did start acting after that. Okay. That's like the natural transition for a comedian is from stage to the screen.
Okay.
Whether that be television, movies. But now it's different because of social media. It's like people is like doing whole series on YouTube.
That is true.
Creating their own shows, creating their own films, and just shooting them themselves.
Now, tell me, okay, you obviously in church, how did that even come about? Because when I used to go to church, man, there was no clowning around. There was no comedy. It was serious.
Yeah, you couldn't have that blonde hair and not in church back in the day.
Exactly.
The devil is a lot. No, no, no. Ain't no Lord of mine going to have you with no yellow hair, as they say, stuff like that. Boy, why you come in here looking like a black and mild? All that kind of stuff. But go ahead.
So how did you get your start in comedy in church then?
So my mom was the, she was like over the programming for the church anniversary service type thing.
Okay.
And I used to be at the crib making fun of my pastor, like imitating him to my mom and my sister. Black pastor, real animated. And the Lord said, I'm going to do it. I'm doing all that in the house. And then my mom said, I'm going to make you do that at the anniversary.
Okay.
And I said to my mom, no, the fuck you not. Can I say that here?
Yeah, you can go ahead, man.
All right, cool. Because if night. I couldn't, it's too late. But I didn't say that, but I said that to my mama. And then after I woke up from the beating, she said, I'm going to still have you do it. So I go to the church, and they call my name. They say, coming to the thing, Brother Lance, because I ain't even talking church. I was quiet. I went on stage and did it. Everybody was laughing. Pastor was laughing. Tears coming down his face. People running around the church laughing. Like it was crazy, right? So I was still thinking, I still wasn't thinking I was going to be a comedian because I didn't even know. I didn't know no comedians. I never met a comedian in person. I seen Def Jam and I seen Kings of Comedy.
Comic View.
Comic View,
mm-hmm.
Which they bring him back.
Mm-hmm.
But I still wasn't like I would be a comedian. And then it wasn't until, at this time, my church is directly across the street from the Punchline.
Mm-hmm.
So it wasn't until I went to the Punchline and watched it live for the first time. I had never seen comedy live, only on television. And I was like, oh, okay. And then I went and did it the next month myself.
So tell me about that. You went into, so first time you've never done it before, but you, you know, you're like, you know what, you got the confidence, right? Because doing it at church, you know, in front of all the church people, you know, is, it takes a lot of confidence. And now you go see it live. Tell me about how that first show went.
First show for me or the first time seeing it live?
First show for you when you
went. First show for me went great, but it didn't start off great. And it's once I got on stage, it started off great. I had trouble getting on the show. I thought it was just an open mic. You can just sign up and they put you on stage, but it wasn't. It was a showcase. And so they don't just put anybody on the showcase. I didn't know that. But, you know, that's when I read the website and all of that. I thought, oh, I can just show up. So I'm talking to the manager. He's like, I'm not putting you on stage. He's like, he would just say mean stuff on purpose. Everybody think they funny until they bomb, then he walk off. And I'm just sitting there like, oh, snap. What happens after I bomb? So he did that. I'm going back and forth with this dude for like 45 minutes, like begging him for stage time.
Right.
Begging for 5 minutes. As I'm having a conversation with him, now this is 2010. There is no Instagram. This is, Facebook is there. I don't have a Twitter. If Twitter even, I don't know when Twitter started, but my point is this was mostly word of mouth. This was mostly you go see people and tell them to come or, you know, maybe, I wasn't even texting like that in 2010. Like, you know what I mean?
Right,
like
right,
everything's
right.
So different now. Like, but anyway, as I'm talking to him, people keep coming in the building, like greeting me, like, hey, do your thing, Lance. Hey, kill it tonight. Hey, can't wait to see you.
And so he's seeing that like people know you.
People come to see me. It's like 60 people came to see me.
Oh, wow.
I didn't know at the time that I just sold a lot of tickets on a Wednesday night with no guest list. These are all paid tickets and it's a 2-drink minimum for everybody. So I just made this place a lot of money.
Right.
On a Wednesday night. I didn't know that. I didn't know I just was wanting to get on stage.
Right.
So at that point, he almost had to put me on stage. I didn't know these things.
Yeah.
I was unaware
with the business
unaware
side of it.
Right? I just was bright-eyed and bushy-tailed, as they say, just wanting to get on stage. Please.
Let me do my thing.
Let me do my thing. So then he said, okay, I'm going to put you up first. I said, all right, cool. I didn't know nothing about going first. I didn't know you were supposed to be nervous. I didn't know none of that. And at this point, I'm upset because I've been arguing with this dude for 45 minutes trying to get on stage. I can't be nervous now. I'm furious. So then when I get up there, no. Then right before the show started, they said, okay, you're going up third. So I'm like, cool, whatever. Now, mind you, I didn't tell anybody who came to see me what was going on because then it would have been an issue.
Right.
You know what I mean? These people might not be as calm as I am about
this.
So then the guy who went right before me, it was, I think they might have laughed more at Rosa Parks' funeral. I'm talking about nobody smiled for 6 minutes. He was just up there.
So the crowd is like dead now.
He was just up there giving a eulogy.
Man.
I'm talking, it was.
And you got to go after him.
6 minutes. So then, now I'm really mad. Like, I didn't have to argue, and he didn't have to argue.
Right.
He just got to go freely and do this in front of all these real people. All right, cool. So then I go up. It went great.
It went great.
Now, I still remember all of my early jokes. Not every detail, but I remember the premises of all of the jokes I wrote early. I was always a good writer, always understood a joke, always understood a punchline. Where I grew the most at was performance, stage presence. That comes with time, with doing it. But I always understood in order for this to work, you have to have this and they have to go together. Always got the concept of a joke.
Now, since you bring up the concept of a joke, how long on average does it take you to come up with a bit?
They're never done.
Ever.
Never done. But once I have something, I can start to work with that. So that could be like for example, like I remember I was in the gym and I seen a dude with his dog in the gym. Yeah, that same thing I did. But then it started this whole joke. right? Mm-hmm. And then it's almost like you ever buy the jeans with the rip in the knee?
Yeah, I might own one pair of those.
Right? You seem like you got a couple pair. You seem like
I might own one pair of those.
You seem like a ripped jean type of guy, you know what I mean? But you know how you ever have it and it's a small rip?
Yeah.
And then over time it's a big, and then before you know it, your whole thigh out, you say, I can't wear these.
Now they're shorts.
Yeah, now they're shorts. You know what I mean? That's how a joke beats me. It might start here and then it just keeps going into something else. So even when the crowd might feel like, oh, that's great, I'm still trying to add to it. I'm still trying to get more out of it.
How can you expand it? How can you branch off from it?
Because it all starts off as a blah, 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 blah. Mm-hmm. But then once you start to add the complexity to it and start to add different analogies and bring these two worlds together and pull that with that, and how can I make this joke that I wrote 7 months ago relevant with this current event thing mm-hmm. that just happened right here? How can I bring those two together? And then, oh, it's election time. How can I make that come with that? You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah. So what about inspiration from like other comedians, man? Like obviously, like from what it sounds like, your story is this: you were born to do this. Like this was what you were supposed to be doing because
I was supposed to be a drug dealer. But what happened was, you know, I don't want to talk about that. Go ahead.
I was gonna say, man, inspiration, comedians, like anybody who like you watched growing up that really kind of like inspired you, or even comedians that you've met that like, you know, kind of gave you the game or gave you some advice where you're like, you know what, like this has really kind of like helped elevate me.
That's a great question. It's a long answer. No, I'm serious.
Okay.
This is a long answer because it has changed a bunch of times. Mm-hmm. So if you ask me comedians who inspired me before I ever got on a stage, right, then we're talking about Sinbad, mm-hmm. we're talking about Eddie Murphy, mm-hmm. we're talking about Tony Roberts, we're talking about Mitch Hedberg, we're talking about Steve Harvey, mm-hmm. also the Kings of Comedy movie, mm-hmm. we're talking about Bernie Mac, but primarily Bernie Mac's Def Jam set. You know, kick in! You just don't understand. I watched that set 475 million times.
I was gonna say, that's interesting that you said Steve Harvey and Bernie Mac right after Steve Harvey, because I was like, they're like two sides of the same coin, but very different styles.
Yeah, but I was watching all these people, like Stephen Wright, mm-hmm. you know, Martin.
Yeah.
You know, so, but this is all before I ever started. Chris Rock, mm-hmm. all before I ever started. And then once I started, then it was a whole new cast of people who inspired me because, you know, I just was more in it. I seen more, right? So that's when I start to really figure out who Patrice O'Neal is, mm-hmm. you know, and that's when I really watched Richard Pryor. I never watched Richard Pryor as a child. I didn't watch Richard Pryor until I started doing comedy, and I really started to understand what was going on. I really started to see, like, oh, a lot of people got a lot from Richard Pryor. Like, I didn't know that, you know what I mean?
So it's like doing your history.
Yeah, I really started to pay attention to Red Fox and Dick Gregory, you know, and then, once again, Tony Roberts again. But Tony Roberts was one of my favorite comedians before I ever met him. And then he became like one of my closest friends, you know what I mean? And then while he's one of my closest friends, he's still my favorite comedian.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Because I watch him every, I talk to him every day, I see him every day, I see how quick and sharp he is with jokes, you know what I mean? I see how fast he is, I see how committed he is to the joke. You know what I mean? And then there was like people who I seen and touched and talked to every day, right? B.T. Kingsley, mm-hmm. Nate Jackson, Rico the Great, Mikey Winfield, mm-hmm. Kev on stage. You know what I mean? It's like, but everybody for different reasons though. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Now, then there's this internet explosion, right? So then it's like, you watching people blow up on the internet. That's a different inspiration. Right, so then it's once again Kev on stage. It's Desi Banks. It's people like King Batch. Yeah. You know what I mean? It's Matt Rife, Ali Sadiq. You know, it's just all. It's just different. It's just different forms of inspiration.
Right.
You know, I don't just watch people who do stand up and say, like, nah, I'm watching how they're getting to certain places and trying to figure that out. Or it's like,
I get you. We're going to dive more into that because you mentioned something that I really want to touch on. But we're going to take a quick break and we'll be right back after these.
Y'all got commercials in here?
Everyday amazing with Sky Alton.
My name is Armani Easley. Continue watching Everyday Amazing with Sky Alton.
Everyday Amazing with Sky Alton.
Welcome back to the show. I'm still here with the funniest Lance Woods. Lance,
the funniest Lance Woods. Like, it's another Lance Woods who also is funny, but not as funny as this Lance Woods. I like how you did that.
trying to, you know, do my own little jokes.
I'm with the blondest Sky Alton.
The blondest right here.
The blondest. You know what I mean? It's somebody else, but his blonde ain't blonde and like this. He got black. His is more cheetah print.
That's why I like comedians, man, because, you know, you guys are always going to bring that energy. And
I like how your hair match your chains. They don't even understand what you're doing.
Right.
They ain't even paying attention to the details. They think this is all accidental.
Nah, man, I put thought into this.
Come on, man. Watch, I'm going to kill these hoes with. They don't know what to do.
Oh, man. Okay, so before we went to break, man, we talked about, just inspirations, right, and how your inspiration has changed depending on, like, if we're talking stand-up, if we're talking before you started doing stand-up. You mentioned, content creating a little bit. And I want to talk a little bit more about that because as technology has evolved, the ability to put out content has evolved, right? And so, obviously, now you don't have to technically be on the stage to do comedy. Now you can put out Instagram clips. You can put out, like, We touched a little bit about behind the scenes, how people just go to the store and just record people and make content out of that. And I noticed for yourself, man, you are one of those people who are always, like, keeping up with current events. Anything viral, you kind of touch on it. So tell me a little bit about how that has helped grow your audience and, like, what you think about stand-up versus creating content, like, online.
Well, those are two different things, but they're one and the same because your stand-up can be the content that you use. The internet is the Wild Wild West. There are no rules. You can do whatever you want on there, right? So there's people who's like frustrated with it, but because they want to be stand-up purists. You can go online and be a stand-up purist. You can literally, every time you go get on stage, you can film it, cut those clips up, and post that on your social media. Mm-hmm. I mentioned Ali Sadiq earlier. Ali Sadiq is selling out theaters now, but primarily, all he posts on his social media is his stand-up clips.
Mm.
He's one of the greatest stand-up comedians who's ever lived. You know what I mean? So he has a lot of content, but it's not just guys like Andrew Schultz. Dude, like there's a lot of guys, Mark Normans, who just primarily post stand-up clips, and they post stand-up clips. Now this content creator word is almost like I had this joke I wrote probably like 10 years ago that I never really tell, but it's like I would tell a girl, she said, what you do for a living? And I say, oh, I'm an application submitter. Nigga, you unemployed. You know what I mean? That's what a lot of content creation sounds like. Mm-hmm. It's like, I'm a content creator. No, you just record stupid shit. You know what I mean? You're not creating but we're in this space now where everything is considered content.
Mm.
So, you know, really, the way that the internet works, so there's words, right, like algorithm.
Mm-hmm.
So if you change the word algorithm to audience, right, so then you say, I got to satisfy the algorithm, or you got to satisfy the audience.
Mm-hmm.
You feel what I'm saying? Yeah. So you're trying to build up your audience. Mm-hmm. And when you have your audience, you feed them what you feed them. You know what I mean? You give them what you give them. You know what I mean? But it's just a thing where it's just content. So people just throw in the content. Just throw in the content. If I'm an Instagram, if I'm a TikTok, their only request is that people stay on the app.
Mm.
So they don't care what you throw in there. Just keep throwing it. As long as people are staying on our app, this is great.
Right.
This is great. Right. So, yeah, you're a content creator. Yeah, yep, that was great. Oh, really? You put your whole foot in the toilet? Yeah, that's content. Yeah, throw it up there. Oh, you ate a bat. Yeah, put it up there. Like, and it's whatever, you know what I mean? So it's like, oh, you like to trip old ladies in Walmart. Great content. And they put, that's how it works, you know what I mean? They're like, as long as people are staying on our app, it works for us.
Yeah.
So.
What? I mean, I think that's an amazing answer. And the reason I brought it up is because, like I said, you are one of the comedians who I feel like embrace both worlds, where, like, you know, you'll find stuff on the internet, right? And then you'll give your version of what you think is going on and give great content from that. And but you also put in the working out here doing stage and giving content in that way. So not, you know, I like that, you know, you hit all marks, right? Like, you ain't just, okay, this is how I create content, you know? And I think, like I said, what you do takes a lot more, in my opinion, takes a lot more skill, because everybody, I feel like, can't do the stage work, right? And
yeah.
So I like that you do that. Speaking of stage work, I think we got some of your work here that we want to show the audience, and maybe you tell us a little bit about.
White people are efficient at Thanksgiving time. Black people, you ain't gonna believe this. Fam, they ate dinner at 11 o'clock in the morning. We still in our pajamas. They done with dessert, getting ready for Christmas by noon. And to my surprise, they ate all the same foods we ate. They all the same food. But they added raisins to all of it. It was macaroni, cheese, and raisins. It was yams with raisins. It was raisin water. It bubbled up like Alka-Seltzer.
Tell me a little bit about that. Now, to me, it looked like you were shining a little bit of your Eddie Murphy raw in that. You know, you had to.
Talking about the jacket?
Yeah.
So I got that jacket and the jeans customly made by man Samuel Rowe. He's a designer right here. So we actually went to the leather store, bought the leather, bought the denim, and he showed me like mock-ups and was like, do you want this kind of jacket? You want this kind of jacket? And he made it. You couldn't see it in there, but like there was leather in the jeans. It was amazing. But that was from the first, technically my second special, but my first special that I really pushed, Undeniable. That's on Amazon, Apple TV. We shot that at the Guild Theater, and it was great. But that joke in particular was because I went to a white Thanksgiving. I didn't know. And every time I say that joke, white people would be like, we don't put raisins in our food. Those is cranberries. But I don't know. A berry's a berry.
Oh yeah. Man, so you know, speaking of specials, I understand you're on tour right now. Tell me a little bit about how the tour is going, and also what's one of your favorite cities to perform in.
So right now I am on the Desi Banks Purpose Chasers tour.
Okay.
Myself, Desi Banks, Detroit Reed, Ronnie Jordan, and no, it's great. Everywhere so far has been great. What was we at last week? We were in Milwaukee, Baltimore before that, but scratch that. Let's talk about Milwaukee last week.
Okay.
So on the flight, listen, where am I? I want to look right at the camera. Where, right here? Check this out. United Airlines flight 5179 with service from Milwaukee to Sacramento. Whoever stole my shoes out my luggage, I hope you get permanent athlete's feet. And they was fake. So how about that? I hope you try to resell them and they cut your thumbs off for trying to resell fake shoes. They stole my Mocha 1 Jordans out my suitcase. They stole my Jordans out my suitcase.
Wow.
And my check bags. And I had a layover in Chicago. We right here again? I had a layover in Chicago for 2.5 hours. I know it was somebody in Chicago who stole my shoes. They took my shoes and my coconut oil. They wanted me to be barefoot and ashy. The nerve of these people.
I mean, you know, we got 2 minutes left in the show. So, but with that, we're going to segue into drawbacks of, you know, this, you know, being a comedian and fame, right? Because.
You want to know the drawbacks? They steal your shoes in the airport. They took my shoes out of my luggage. You don't know, my grandma could have gave me them shoes. She didn't, but what if she did? How would you feel? I hope you walking like Kaiser Soze right now. I'm pigeon toed and it's contagious. Bet you didn't know that.
Okay, so drawbacks is TSA, man.
Yeah, no, I mean, every drawback that comes from it is not a drawback to me. Mm-hmm. You know, this is a blessing. It's a blessing to have a level of influence over, you know, the world, to be able to inspire people. You get a lot of free stuff. You get into places.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
I'm still trying to experience. I ain't on that level yet.
Nah, man, it'll happen. You just, I'm telling you, the more money you get, the less they ask you to pay for stuff.
Really?
You get more money, they say, nah, dinner's on us.
Okay.
Really?
Okay. This is why
wasn't it on you when I didn't have it? I would have loved this free meal when I needed it. I don't need this free food now, but I'll take it. Every bite. Yum, 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 yum.
I'm still trying to get to that level.
I'm telling you.
I'm still paying full price for my meals.
Hey, man, listen. It's going to happen for you. It's going to happen. You know why it's going to happen for you? Because you don't steal shoes out of suitcases. United Flight 5179 from Milwaukee with a layover in Chicago. I'm telling you, it was some Jordan 1s, the Mocha joints. This is my first time wearing them. I've had the shoes for a year, never wore them. I said, I'm going to bring them out this weekend. Bring them out, and now they go.
Well, I want to thank you again, Mr. Sir Lance Woods, for coming on the show and sharing your story, your journey into Milwaukee, man. You know,
no, I think it was Chicago. We're not going. Well, I can't be for sure.
Oh.
I was flying from Milwaukee to Chicago. The flight from Milwaukee to Chicago was 20 minutes.
Oh, okay.
So 20-minute flight. Then I had a 2.5-hour layover in Chicago. So I don't want to put this on Chicago, but
okay.
Y'all know who y'all is.
Well, I want to thank you again for coming on the show, man, and sharing, you know, your story, your journey. You know, I want you to tell the people where they can, you know, check out your specials and tell them that where they can see the tour at.
Everything. Go all my social media. Sir Lance Woods on everything. SirLanceWoods. Sir Lance Woods. You'll find the tour information, all that stuff there. Coming to a city near you. We in Denver coming up, Omaha coming up. We go to Dallas soon. We go all over the world, man, so make sure y'all tap in. And for Sacramento, I do a show once a month here, so at the Punchline. And I'll be at Lattice Unlimited in April. So, yeah, just tap in. Go to my social media. Everything will be there, and I hope y'all come out. I bet you I won't have no Jordan 1 mochas on. Why? Because they stole them. I ain't going to keep talking about this. But I'm going to let God deal with it. But I'm telling you, they took the shoes out of my bag. Gone.
This has been another episode of Everyday Amazing with Sky Alton. Be sure to check out the next episode. And then you always want to catch up past episodes on Everyday Amazing with Sky Alton on YouTube. You can find me on Instagram at Everyday Amazing with Sky Alton. Until next time, I'll see you then. Lance Woods, everybody. Lance Woods.
Everyday Amazing with Sky Alton. Everyday Amazing. Everyday amazing, Sky Alton. Everyday amazing. Everyday amazing, Sky Alton.